On the 21st day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Born.
Nothing, Mr. Mushnick.
So she finally decides to come to work.
Good morning, Mr. Mushnick.
What morning? It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Not that we had a customer. Who has a customer when you win a flower shop on Skid Row?
I'm sorry.
Seymour, what's going on back there?
Very little, Mr. Mushnick.
Audrey. You better go back there and see what he's... Audrey! Where'd you get that shiner?
Shiner?
Audrey, that greasy boyfriend of yours, he's been beating up on you again, hasn't he? Look, I know it's none of my business, but maybe I don't think he's such a nice boy.
You don't meet nice boys when you live on Skid Row, Mr. Mushnick.
I got these plants repotted for you, Mr.
Seymour, look what you've done to the inventory.
Don't yell at Seymour, Mr. Mushnick.
Hi, Audrey. You look radiant today. Is that new eye makeup?
I'll clean it up before any of the customers get here.
Well, that ought to give you plenty of time. Look, God, what an existence I got. Misfit employees, bums on the sidewalk. Business is lousy. My life is a living hell. You, urchins. Off the stoop. It ain't bad enough I got the winos permanently decorating the storefront. I need 3 worthless ragamuffins adding on to the picture.
We ain't bothering nobody, are we, Crystal?
No, we're not, Renee.
You ought to be in school.
We're on the split shift.
Right. We went to school to the 5th grade, then we split.
Then how do you intend on bettering yourselves?
Better ourselves? Mister, when you from Skid Row, ain't no such thing. Along goes Office 7, and he's on uptown. You'll put your 8 hours for the powers that have always been.
Sing it, child.
Till it's 5.
Down where the cats don't
flop.
Downtown, where the hot pets flop in the snow.
I've always been poor. I keep asking God what I'm for, and he tells me, gee, I'm not sure. Sweep that floor, kid. Oh, I started life as an orphan, a child of the streets here on Skid Row. He took me and gave me shelter, a bed, crust of bread, and a job. Treats me like dirt, calls me a slob with giants. Life's a mess, you live
downtown,
where depression's just status quo.
Down on Skid Row.
Someone show me a way to get out of here, 'cause I constantly pray I'll get out of here. Please won't somebody say I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot or I'll rot here.
Downtown.
Show me how and I will all get out of here.
Downtown.
I'll start climbing uphill and get out of here.
Downtown.
Someone tell me where I still can get out of here. Someone tell Lady Luck that
when
I'm stuck here.
Tears
should be swell to get out of here.
Downtown.
Been the gutter that well and get out of here.
Downtown,
I love heaven and hell to get out of Skid.
Oh,
I don't know what to get out of Skid. But a hell of a lot to get out of Skid.
Feels
better than far away out of Skid. But believe me, I've got to get out of Skid.
Look at that. 6 o'clock and we didn't sell so much as a single fern. Don't bother coming in tomorrow.
You don't mean?
What don't I mean? I'm closed. Forget it, kaput.
No, you can't.
I'm closing this goddamn customer forsaken place.
Oh, Mr. Mushnick, forgive me for saying so, but has it ever occurred to you that maybe what the firm needs is to move in a new direction?
What Seymour's trying to say, Mr. Mushnick, is, well, we've talked about it and we both agree. Seymour, why don't you run in back and bring out that strange and interesting new plant you've been working on? You see, Mr. Mushnick, some of those plants Seymour's been tinkering around with are really unusual. And we were thinking maybe some of those strange and interesting plants, prominently displayed and advertised, would attract business.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
There, now wasn't that bizarre?
At least. What kind of weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of flytrap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. So I gave it my own name. I call it an Audrey, too.
After me?
I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, maybe...
Maybe what? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't just suddenly...
Excuse me. I couldn't help but notice that strange and interesting plant. What is it?
It's an Audrey, too!
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Well, where'd you get it?
Well, you remember that total eclipse of the sun a couple weeks ago?
da-do.
I was walking in the wholesale flower district that day.
Shoot, da-do.
And I passed by this place where this old Chinese man,
Shane, da-do.
He sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings.
Snip, da-do.
Cause he knows, you see, strange plants are my hobby.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-do.
He had nothing unusual there that day.
No, da-do.
And I was about to, well, you know, walk on by.
Good for you.
When suddenly, and without warning, there was this
total eclipse of the sun.
It got very dark, and I heard a strange humming sound like something from another world.
Da-do.
And then, when the light came back, this weird plant was just sitting there.
Oopsie-doo.
Just stuck in, you know, among the zinnias.
Audrey too.
I could have sworn I hadn't been there before, but the old Chinese man sold it to me anyways. For $1.95.
Well, that's a fascinating story and an interesting plant. While I'm here, I may as well take $50 worth of your finest roses.
$50?
$50?
$50? Oh. 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 Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Oh, do you have change for 100?
100? I'm afraid the register's closed for today.
Well then, I guess I'll just have to take twice as many, won't I?
Twice as many?
Twice as many?
Twice as many? Yes, sir! $100 worth. Archie, my darling, kindly fetch this young gentleman here. $100 worth of our very finest red American beauty roses.
Thank you very much. Yes, sir, that's a strange and interesting plant.
Wow. Well, don't just stand there. Put that plant, what do you call it?
An Audrey 2?
Put that Audrey 2 by the window so passersby can see. I would have never believed it. Well, my children, I'm taking this all to dinner.
Mr. Mushnick, I'd love to, but I've got a date.
With that same no good Nick. Archie, you don't need a date with him. You need Major Medical. What I'm saying is, he's not such a nice boy.
He's a professional.
What kind of professional wears a leather jacket and drives a motorcycle?
He's a rebel, Mr. Mushnick. He makes good money. And besides, he's the only fellow I've got. Well, enjoy dinner. Good night, Seymour.
Good night.
Poor girl.
Well, are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Quellborn. You're staying right here and taking care of this sick plant. How come it's fainting all the time?
I told you it's been giving me trouble. It just wilts like this. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Strictly between you and me. Neither is the Audrey 1.
If only I knew what breed it is, what genus, but it's nowhere in the books.
Well, my advice to you, Seymour, is you better figure it out. And fast. Look what this exotic little beauty has done for business.
I know.
So work, Seymour. Nurse this sick plant back to health. I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix! Oh. Good night.
Oh, Tui, I don't know what else to do for you. Mr. Mushnick and Audrey, they just met you, but I've been going through this for weeks. Grow and wilt, spurt and flop. Are you sickly little planner? You just plan stubborn. What is it you want? What is it you need?
I've given you sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly, I'm down on my knees. Now please grow for me. I've given you sunshine and water to sip. I've given you potash, you've given me zip. Oh God, how I missed you. Oh pot, how you tease. Now please grow for me. I've given you southern exposure to get you to thrive. I've pinched your back hard like I'm supposed to. You're barely alive. I've tried you at levels of moisture from desert to mud. I've given you grow lights and mineral supplements. What do you want from me, blood? Ouch! Damn roses, damn thorns. Clumsy me. Hey, Tui, look what I did. Hey, you're opening up. I wonder what made you do that. Oh, I think I know what made you do that. Well, I guess a little couldn't hurt, as long as you don't make a habit out of it or anything. I've given you sunshine, I've given you rain. Looks like you're not happy, lest I open a vein. I'll give you a few drops, if that'll appease. Now please, oh, please. Grow for me?
This concludes our interview with Seymour Carelborn, the young botanical... Do you mind if I call you a genius?
Gosh, no.
The young genius who has discovered a new form of plant life hitherto unknown on this planet, the Audrey 2. Just one more question, Mr. Carelborn. Do you feed it anything special?
Special? No. It's a secret formula, but it's, not hard to come by.
Well, thank you for stopping by, and...
I'd like to remind our listeners that the Audrey 2 is on display exclusively at Mushnick Skid Row Florists.
Well, thank you.
Open
this
6 days a week.
Radio station
10 to 6.
WSKID.
The address. The address. Mention the address. It's still great advertising. Can't believe it. It couldn't be happening. Pinch me, girl. It couldn't be happening. All of this sudden success. Coming out of the blue. I put a sign up right in the front window. An advertisement right in the front window. Stop in and see the amazing new plant Audrey 2. And a really remarkable thing is that people, they do. See more that twerp of a clutch finally did something right. Audrey 2 drives him nuts. What a blessing this wonderful plant should exist and should awaken the buck for me hand over fist. Well, how'd I do?
Oh, you was great, Seymour!
You're sexier than a wolf, man.
But you didn't mention the address of the shop. How many times do I have
to tell you? I was nervous. Where's Audrey? She said she'd be here.
Forget about Audrey. I got 3 more interviews lined up for tomorrow, and the Skid Row Herald Examiner wants a picture.
If I had a mother, she'd be so happy.
You're an overnight sensation, Seymour. Who'd have believed it? One day he pushed a broom, nothing in his news but gloom and doom. Then he lit a fuse and give him room. Stand aside and watch that mother blow. Explosion, banker boom. Don't you go to show, you never know. Seymour was in a funk. He was number zero. Who'd have thought?
hero, but just a punk. He was a forgotten so-and-so. Then one day,
crass kerplunk.
Don't it go to show you never know.
Sit down, before my neck don't sing for you. All the world used to screw him. Bit wham pow, now they interview him. And they clamor to put his remarks on the air. All the world used to hate him. Now they're starting to appreciate him. And now because of that strange little plan over there. Observe him, here's a chap. Everything is landing in his lap.
I just cut my hand down in a snap. Something out of Edgar Allan Poe has happened.
Sam Cassatt, don't it go to show you never know. One day you're slinging hash, feeling so rejected, lightning flash. You'll get resurrected, make a splash. Now you're at the brick graffiti mall. And with the thunder crash, crash kerplunk. Banker boom, zanker zonk, Sam kazoom, zowie powie, holy cow, he ordered up a rainbow to go. Wow, pal, look out below, don't it go to show you never know.
Sure are.
And sure did.
Oh, Seymour's first radio broadcast. I wanted to cheer him on. I tried to be on time, but...
Don't tell me.
You got tied up.
No, just handcuffed a little.
Girl, I don't know who this man says you're hanging out with, but he is hazardous to your health.
Well, that's for sure, but I can't leave him.
And why not?
Because he'd get angry. And if he does this to me when he likes me, imagine what he'd do if he ever got mad.
So, don't the chump and get another guy and let him protect you.
And we got one all picked out.
A little botanical genius.
And she ain't talking about George Washington Carver.
Seymour?
Bingo!
We're just friends. I could never be Seymour's girl. Got a past.
And who amongst us has not?
I don't even deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
Mm-mm-mm. She suffers from low self-image.
You have a point.
She have a problem.
I know Seymour's the greatest, but I'm dating a semi-sadist. So I got a black eye and my arms in a cast. Still, that Seymour's a cutie. Well, if not, he's gotten a beauty. And I dream of a place where we can be together at last.
And what kind of place is that, honey? An emergency room?
Oh, no. It's just a daydream of mine. A little development I dream of, just off the interstate. Not fancy like Levittown. Just a little street and a little suburb, far, far from urban Skid Row. The sweetest, greenest place, where everyone has the same little lawn out front and the same little flagstone patio out back. And all the houses are so neat and pretty, because they all look just alike. Oh, I dream about it all the time. Just me and the toaster and a sweet little guy like Seymour. A matchbox of our own, a fence of a real chain link, a grill out on the patio, disposals in the sink. A washer and a dryer and an ironing machine. In the tract house that we share,
somewhere that's green. He rakes and trims the grass. He loves to mow and weed. I cook like Betty Crocker, and I look like Donna Reed. There's plastic on the furniture to keep it neat and clean. And the pine saw scented air somewhere that's green. Between a frozen dinner and our bedtime, 9:15, we snuggle watching Lucy on our big, enormous 12-inch screen. I'm his December bride. He's father, he knows best. Our kids watch Howdy Doody as the sun sets in the west. A picture out of Better Homes and Gardens magazine. Far from Skid Row, I dream we'll go.
Renovation first, whipping up and brooming, cause business has been thriving and customers are flocking. We need refrigeration in our new improved display, so we're closed for renovation today.
Yes indeed, this is the flooring shop you heard about on Channel 5 News. The RD2 is displayed exclusively here.
We're closed for decoration, cause fortune has been smiling. So now we're due for painting, new plumbing and retiling. We'll make a shift shape show place of our little shop, and then tomorrow we'll be open again.
Aren't you finished yet?
I'm trying my best, but these band-aids make it kind of hard.
You've been getting hard so much lately.
I know. It seems like every time I pick up a pruning shear, I slip.
We're closed for decoration, cause walking down and brooming, cause business has been thriving since Audrey 2's been blooming. The phones have not stopped ringing with the customers who say,
another bunch of peonies,
another dozen daisies, please,
geraniums and amonies,
forgive me nuts and fleur de lis,
with gratis home deliveries, unpaid in full and COD. We're closed for renovation today.
Did you send out that order to Mrs. Shiver?
Mrs. Shiver?
Oh, Mrs. Shiver!
Oh, Mrs. Shiver, I forgot.
You forgot? Oh, how could you forget an order like that? The Shivers are our most important funereal account. Oh. A big, enormous family, and they're dropping off like flies. I told you, Crowborn, if we lose business over this, you are finished.
Sometimes I think Mr. Mushnick's too hard on you.
Oh, I don't mind. After all, I owe him everything. He took me out of the Skid Row home for boys when I was just a little tyke. Gave me a warm place to sleep, under the counter. Nice things to eat like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep and toilets to clean and every other Sunday off.
I think you ought to raise your expectations. Now that we're getting successful, I mean, why don't you start with some new clothes? Oh, no offense, but Well, with all the interviews and photo sessions, a big important experimental botanist has to look the part.
I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste, like you.
Well, I could help you pick things out.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
In a public place, like a department store?
Sure.
Tonight?
Oh, I can't tonight. I've got a date. But I'd like to go with you some other time.
Sure. I'll pencil you in.
I bet you got a lot of dates now, huh?
Oh, not dates exactly, but a lot of garden clubs have been calling, asking me to give lectures.
Gee.
Imagine me giving lectures. I never even finished grade school.
Me neither.
Oh, but have you ever flown in an airplane?
No, me neither.
Or eaten a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's?
Me neither.
Or ridden a motorcycle?
It's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous. Gee, I'd better go fix my face. My date will be here any minute.
Excuse me, ladies. I'm looking for a 1313 Skid Row.
I'm afraid that information had to cost you a dollar.
Hey, no prob.
It's right over there. But if you're like the thousands of others flocking down here to see the Audrey 2, you better come back tomorrow, man. That shop is closed for the day. Oh, took his dollar.
I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date?
You're not by any chance talking about a girl with a black eye?
And several other medical problems.
Well, as a matter of fact.
That's him!
That's the one!
Who do you think you are treating her that way?
Whoa, ladies,
don't come
ladies,
back.
Ladies,
beat
ladies,
it.
Get lost.
Please, I'm friendly, peace. You, want some nitrous oxide?
Why don't you get lost, my talentless brains? The last thing Audrey needs is one of your kind.
My kind is a very nice kind, ladies. Not a monster.
And what else would you call it?
I'd call it, I'd call it an occupational hazard.
Say what?
You see, ladies, my, line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. Oh, this stuff's great! Allow me to explain. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did. Like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat and bash in its head. That's when my mama said,
what did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay. You'll be a dentist.
You'll be a dentist.
You've got a talent for causing things pain.
Hey.
Son, be a dentist. People will pay you to be inhumane. Your temperament's wrong for the priesthood. And teaching will suit you still less. Son, be a dentist.
You'll be a success. Yes. Oh my gosh!
He's a dentist and he'll never ever be any good.
Who wants their teeth done by the market side?
Oh, that hurts! I don't know!
Shut up! Open wide! Here I come! I am your dentist.
Goodness gracious!
And I enjoy the career that I've picked.
Love it.
Pain I inflict. When I start extracting those molars, you girls will be screaming like holy rollers. And though it may cause my patients distress, somewhere in heaven above me, I know that my mama's proud of me. 'Cause I'm a dentist. And a success. Say ah.
Ah.
Say ah!
Ah?
Say ah!
Ah!
Now spit. Hi, how you doing?
Oh, fine, thank you, but you'll have to leave. The shop's closed.
No, I'm not here at shop. Hey, this must be that new plant they're talking about on the news. What do you call it?
An Audrey 2.
Cute name. Catchy. Nice plant. Big.
Thank you. I raised it myself. Now, if you don't mind...
Here, it's some kind of new species or something.
That's what they tell me, but you'll have to leave now. I'm not allowed to let anyone in the shop.
Oh, it's okay, Seymour. This is my boyfriend, Seymour Orin Scrivillo. CDS.
Let me tell you something, guy. You say you raised this thing, right?
Right.
Well, I sure as hell wouldn't be keeping it under a barrel down in some Skid Row dump like this. This thing could be your ticket to the stars. Take it to any florist shop in town and name your price. Hell, somebody make you a damn partner to get their hands on this thing.
Oh, I don't care. I'm happy here.
Seymour's very loyal.
Somebody talking to you!
Oh, no. Excuse me.
Excuse me what?
Excuse me, doctor.
That's better. Now, like I was saying, this thing's a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of here and take the plant with you. Mushnick Skid Row florists. It's like a joke. You hear me talking?
I hear ya.
He hears him.
Shouldn't we be leaving now? I'm sorry.
Sorry what?
I'm sorry, doctor.
Yeah, you gotta train him, huh, stud? All right, well, my bike's outside and double parked, but you think about what I said, Scout. I mean it, you think about that.
Sure, I'll think about it.
You do that. Audrey, got the handcuffs?
Oh, yes. They're right here in my bag.
Let's go.
He'll think about it.
I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnick. And you'd hear the way he talks to Audrey.
Gotta know him or the little kid just said he'll mull it over.
No wonder she looks so unhealthy. It's enough to make you sick.
If he left me, if Seymour left me, why then I'd be right back where I started, which was broken stopping.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince, not a sadistic creep like him.
Close to bankrupt.
What a louse.
Be said, be buttle and bereft. That's what I'd be if Seymour left.
He's a disgrace to the dental profession.
Seymour!
Sir?
Seymour. How would you like to be my son? How would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked you much before, but count the cash that's in the drawer. I've got no choice, I'm much too poor. Say yes.
What for?
Seymour, I want to be your dad. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left the stench, but now I see that you're a mentor. I'm proposing be my son. Mushnick and son. Sounds great. Three words with the ring of fate. So say you'll incorporate with me. A florist dream come true. Mushnick and his boy to you. What business will do for FTD? How about it, Seymour, be my son? Just say the word, I'll get my lawyer on the phone.
Now, Mr. Mushnick, don't be rash. You always said that I was trash.
Oh, I was joking.
Sir, I'm joking.
Choose the physical expression of my pride, of the sweet paternal nishigas I held bent up inside. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah! Gee.
So?
Well...
Well,
I,
you, go ahead and say it, Seymour. Tell me that you will.
Gee, I'd really like to,
but I'll hold my breath until.
Okay, you win, oh, I'll be your son.
Oh, hooray, you win, you'll be my son.
Drop the papers that I'm touched, I really am. And when you reach age 83, I'll let you come move in with me.
You swear?
I promise.
What a son.
Mushnick and son, that's that. Officially, I'm your brat. Consider the matter closed and done.
are senior and junior sick, through thin and through thick, through sloppy and slick. So come kiss me quick.
Please don't make me sick.
Mushnik and Son.
His son. I'm his son. Sudden changes surround me. Lady Luck came and found me. Thanks a million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet Petunia, Mushnik's taken a junior. And someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Oh, Tui, who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? So what if I've had a few dizzy spells, a little lightheadedness? It's been worth it, old pal. Well, I'm a little hungry. I'm gonna run down to Smendrick's and get a bite to eat. I'll see you in the morning. Oh, here we go again. Ugh. Look, I haven't got much left. Just give me a few more days to heal, all right? Then we'll start again on the left hand.
Feed me.
I beg your pardon?
Feed me.
Tui, you talked. You opened your trap. You're thinking you said...
Feed me, Krellbone. Feed me now.
I can't.
I'm starving.
Oh, maybe I can squeeze a little more out of this one.
I need some food.
I know, but you can't get blood from a turnip.
No.
I haven't got any more. What do you want me to do? Slit my wrists? Look, how about I run down to the corner and get you a nice rare roast beef?
Must be blood.
Tui, that's disgusting.
Must be food.
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
Where am I supposed to get it?
Right, boy, you can do it. Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. Cause if you feed me, Seymour, I can grow up big and strong.
You eat blood, RG2. Let's face it, how am I supposed to keep on feeding you? Kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all a coincidence, baby? The sudden success around here, your adoption papers.
Look, you're a plant, an inanimate object.
Does this look inanimate to you, punk? If I can talk and I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want?
Like what?
Like deliver, pal. Like see you get everything your secret, greasy heart desires. Would you like a Cadillac car? Or get shot on jackpot. How about a date with Hedy Lamarr? You're gonna get it.
No thanks, Tui. Kind of you to offer, but...
How'd you like to be a big wheel? Dining out for every meal. I'm the plant who can make it all real. You're gonna get it. I'm your genie. I'm your friend. I'm your willing slave. Take a chance. Just feed me, and you know the kind of eats, the kind of red hot treats, the kind of sticky, thicky sweets I crave. Come on, Seymour, don't be a putz. Trust me, and your life will surely rival King Tut. Show a little initiative, work up the guts, and you'll get it.
I don't know. I don't know. I have so many strong reservations.
You didn't have nothing till you met me. So come on, kid, what'll it be? Money? Girls? One particular girl? How about that Audrey? Think it over. There must be someone you could 86 real quiet like and get me some lunch. How's about a room at the Ritz, wrapped in velvet it covered in glitz. A little nookie gonna clean up your zits and you'll get it.
Gee, I'd like a Harley machine.
Now you're
tooling
cooking
around like I was James Dean.
Yeah.
Making all the guys on the corner turn green.
So go get it. And if you wanna be profound and you really gotta justify, take a breath and look around. A lot of folks deserve to die.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. That's not a very nice thing to say.
But it's true, isn't it?
No, I can't think of anyone who deserves to be chopped up and fed to a hungry plant.
Sure you do.
Stupid woman! Friggin' scatterbrain!
I'm sorry, Doctor! I'm sorry, Doctor!
Get in there and pick up your damn sweater, you dizzy cow!
Yes, Doctor, right away, Doctor! Hi, Seymour, I left my sweater here before—
Come on, move it, you little slut! How do you like that stupid dame? Look at the friggin' sweater! Jeez, if your stupid head weren't screwed on—
Oh, that hurts!
Move it!
If you want a rationale, it isn't very hard to see. Stop and think it over, pal. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. He's so nasty, treating her rough.
Smacking around and always talking so tough.
You need blood and he's got more than enough.
I need blood and he's got more than enough.
You need blood and he's got more than enough.
So go get it.
Next.
Oh, I guess that's me.
Got an appointment?
We met yesterday. Seymour Krelborn.
Oh, that's right. The guy with the plant.
Right.
The band-aids.
Right.
And the gun.
Right.
So why are you pointing a gun at me, Seymour? Hey, are you a little bit nervous about visiting the dentist?
No, I'm not nervous.
It's only gonna hurt a little.
No, you don't understand. I don't like teeth cleaning.
Of course you want your teeth cleaned. Now, say ah.
No.
Say ah! Woo, kid, your mouth's a mess. You got cavities, you got plaque, you're impacted, you're abscess.
I am.
Oh, you're gonna need a complete oral examination. We'll start with that wisdom tooth.
No.
Rip that little bugger out of there, what do you say?
I gotta go.
Hey, there's always time for dental hygiene, Seymour. Have you ever seen the results of a neglected mouth? See this, Seymour? This could happen to you.
It could?
Unless I take immediate action. Let's get started.
Wait, aren't you gonna give me Novocaine?
What for? Dulls the senses.
But it'll hurt.
Only till you pass out.
Oh. What's that?
This is a drill, Seymour.
It's rusty.
It's an antique. Oh. They don't make instruments like this anymore. Sturdy, heavy, dull. This is gonna be a challenge. This is gonna be a pleasure. I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide.
Oh, thank God. I thought you weren't gonna use any.
Well, the gas isn't for you, Seymour. It's for me. You see, I really want to enjoy this, and I find a little giggle gas before we begin increases my pleasures enormously. In fact, I'm gonna want my special gas mask for this one. You just relax, Seymour. I'll be with you in a moment.
Now, do it now, why he's gassing himself to a palatable stupor. The timing's ideal and the moment is super to ready and fire and blow the sick bastard away. Now, do it now, just a flicker of pressure right here on the trigger, and Oz, you won't have to put up with that pig for another day. Now, for the girl, now, for the plant, now, yes, I will. But I can't.
Seymour, I am flagging now. Oh, the things we're gonna do to your mouth. Okay, I guess I've had about enough of this stuff. I'll just take the mask off now and... Guess what, Seymour?
What?
It's stuck.
What?
The mask, it's stuck. Can't get it off. Jeez, I could asphyxiate in here. Seymour, hey Seymour, give me a head, will you?
Well?
He says, well? Seymour, I don't think you understand. Don't be fooled if I should chuckle like a happy, sappy dope. It's just the gas. It's got me high. But don't let that fact deceive you. Any moment I could die. Though I giggle and I chortle, bear in mind I'm not immortal. Why this whole thing strikes me funny, I don't know. Cause it really is a rotten way to go.
What we have here is an ethical dilemma. Lest I help him get the gadget when he doesn't have a prayer. True, the gun was never fired, but the weave is transpired. I can finish him with simple laissez-faire. What
no.
we have here is a tricky moral problem. Should
let
I help him
now.
With a mask and let him go for like a bear?
Do
could
it
shoot
now.
Him when I tried, but the fates are on my side.
No.
I get off the guy by staying in the
chair. Don't be fooled if I should giggle like hyenas in a zoo. It's just the gas. It turns me on. But don't let my mirth deceive you. Any moment I'll be gone. The vital signs are failing cause the oxide I'm inhaling makes it difficult as hell to catch my breath. Are you dumb? Hard of hearing? Or relieved? My end is nearing. Are you satisfied? I've laughed myself to...
Death?
Please hold.
Audrey,
be right with you.
How may I help you? Oh. Yes,
That's the plan for fine.
Be told, I'll do be right with you.
Mushnick and Sons get rolls for every forest. How may I help you?
Oh. Audrey, I'm late for the lawyer. Tell Seymour, make sure Corman gets his wolf spain.
Seymour, could you help me with these phones?
Oh. Mushnick and Sons, Skid Row's favorite florist. Can you hold, please?
Now you were saying. Flowers for a prom corsage.
Flowers for an entourage.
Flowers to a funeral home.
Leaving from St. Andrew's Roman Catholic Church at 9th and Vine.
$40, hold the line.
First thing in the morning, we'll be there in the morning.
Can you hold the Rose Bowl? Seymour, the Rose Bowl. You know that big inflated estimate we wrote for the Rose Bowl. Well, it's the Rose Bowl. Seems they want to buy the flowers here for every single float. You can't keep the tournament waiting.
Mushnick and Sun, please hold.
Can you hold?
It's just as the plan foretold.
Just a minute.
It's business like who'd have ever guessed.
Mushnick and Sun.
That was me.
Please wait.
That was me.
The business
on Channel 3.
So why am I feeling so depressed?
I get 2 tickets to the game. Mushnick and Sun, Skid Row's favorite florists.
7,000 boutonnieres, carnations or the yellow roses.
Please, I've only got 2 ears, allergic to chrysanthemums.
Hollyhocks or hardia, which one would your wife prefer?
Were you waiting long? I'm sorry, sir, 1 minute and I'll get her for you.
Seymour, that reporter.
Her, I thought we finished yesterday.
She wants another interview, said to bring the plan with you.
Audrey, it's the new account.
Sorry, that's the right amount.
Daisy's only come in white.
Sir, I'm sworn not to fight.
Sorry, those are out of stock.
Seymour, look, it's 6 o'clock.
Call back in the morning, will you?
Call back in the morning, won't you?
Call back in the morning, can you?
Call back in the morning, thank you.
Call back in the morning.
Seymour, could you lock up for me? I'm all in.
Oh, 1 minute, Audrey. I want to show you something.
Can it wait till tomorrow?
Oh, it'll just take a second. I went shopping for a new wardrobe, like you told me, and well, ta-da, what do you think?
Seymour!
You don't like it?
Oh, I don't know. Oh,
I'll take it off. I'll take it back. Oh, I'll burn it. Just please don't cry. Oh, look what I did. I only bought it to impress you. That's all I ever meant to do.
I don't know what's come over me. I guess I've just been a little under the weather lately.
It's Oren, isn't it? You've been down to the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I never felt so relieved as to when they told me he'd vanished. It was like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I've saved on Epsom salt and Ace bandages.
Then what's the matter?
I feel guilty, I guess. I mean, if he met with foul play or some terrible accident of some kind, then it's partly my fault, you see. Because secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, don't waste 1 more minute worrying about that creep. There's a lot of guys that would give anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
I don't deserve a nice guy.
That's not true.
You don't know the half of it. I've led a terrible life.
Audrey, don't.
I deserve a creep like Oren Scrivillo. DDS. Do you know where I met him? The gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spot. I used to work there on my nights off when we weren't making much money. I'd put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones like this. Low and nasty apparel and I'd...
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You have nothing to be ashamed of. You're a very nice person, and I always knew you were, underneath the bruises and the handcuffs. You know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you.
You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Nobody ever treated me kindly. Daddy left early, Mama was poor. I'd meet a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers, me, I'd say sure. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside.
Bad times are clean washed away.
Please understand that it's still strange and frightening. For losers like I've been, it's so hard to say.
Suddenly Seymour,
He purified.
Plot is thickening amongst my employees.
Please, Mr. Daddy.
Don't you, Mr. Daddy, be Krellborn. Audrey, I was wondering if you can excuse Seymour and me. Perhaps you'd like to go visit your dentist friend.
That's not very funny, Dad. You know he disappeared.
Oh, that's right. Forgive me, poor chick.
What? Seymour, what's he talking about? What's he doing?
You better run along like he asked, Audrey. I'll catch up with you later. I'll call for you if that's okay.
Of course. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushnick.
Little red dots all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, Pop.
I had a pretty strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Yes. It seems they made a routine investigation into the disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, they found a Mushnick Skid Row florist bag. In his office!
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. Then I began to think about certain things I've noticed around here lately. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch and it stained.
Mm-hmm. Hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they remove our garbage only once a month.
Where are you going?
If you want something disposed in a hurry, it's best not to do it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform.
Got your number now.
I saw it last week and didn't think twice.
You know just what you've done.
And the little red dot seemed innocent enough.
You got no place to hide.
Then I catch you kissing the dentist's girlfriend.
You got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a motive.
He knows your life a crime.
Once he's out of the way, you'll move in, right?
I think it's a...
I'm innocent!
Then how do you explain this?
A picture of a baseball cap?
Your baseball cap, Seymour! The police found it in Scavello's office, showed it to me, and asked if I could identify it.
Did you?
No! They don't suspect you at all, Seymour.
but they don't know about the dots. The uniform, the girlfriend.
I didn't do it.
Then come with me to the police and tell them that.
He's got his facts all straight.
Just so my conscience will rest easy.
You know he's on your trail.
You don't. I'll tell them myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
Now will you come?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
He's USDA parole.
Okay, I'll go lock up. We'll head over.
Your future with Audrey.
Come on, come on. Ain't no time to turn squeamish. Oh, come on, come on. I swear on all my spores. When he's gone, the world will be yours.
Okay, Seymour, let's go.
Wait, don't you want to collect the day's receipts so you can deposit them in the morning?
You put them in the safe, didn't you?
No.
What? It's thousands of dollars. Where is it?
Well, I put it in the plant.
In the plant?
Mm-hmm. I thought that, you know, be the safest place. No thief would look in there, right?
The money's inside the plant. How am I supposed to get it?
Just knock.
Knock!
Please, girls, not now.
Is it true that the tour is marshal for the Rosebud?
Is it the truth that the shop is decorating the senior prom?
Yes, it's all true now, please.
There's another big hotshot looking for you, Seymour. He's from uptown. He's been asking all over where he can find you. You're famous, Seymour.
Is that him?
That's him, Mr. Bernstein.
Thank you, girls. Seymour Grillborn, sweetie, honey, baby, pussycat.
Do I know you?
Of course not, but are you gonna be happy when you do? Seymour, sweetheart, doll face, blah, blah, blah. Hey, Seymour Grillborn, you prince, you. My name is Bernstein, I'm with NBC. I came down here to convince you to do a weekly TV show for me. Seymour Krailborn's gardening tips. You like it? I love it. We'll have an hour on Sundays at 4. TV's first home gardening program. You make a mint and our ratings will soar.
They say the big show inherits. You know the book doesn't lie. It's not a question of merit. It's not the man of the lie. They say the meek gonna get it, and you're a meek little guy. You know the meek are gonna get what's coming to them by and by.
Your own TV show, your name and lights. Sign it.
Sign that contract.
Isn't it exciting?
Here he is, Mrs. Sleuth. We found him. Here he is.
Please, girls, I don't want to talk to anyone else.
My darling, my precious, my sweet, sweet thing. So delighted to make your acquaintance. Cutie,
Sweetness, Seymour, baby doll, I'd like a word with you, lover. I'm sure you know me, the editor's wife. We want your face on the cover of the December 3rd issue of Life. Yes, the front of Life magazine. Now that's an honor we so seldom grant. We'll send someone down, let's say Thursday, for shots of you and your beautiful plant.
Instead of Nick, Sean, Terrence, you know the book doesn't lie. It's not a question of merit, it's not the man and supply. They say the meek gonna get it, and you're a meek little guy. You know the meek are gonna get what's coming to them by and by.
Life magazine? Oh my gosh, see where you're gonna make it straight to the top.
How did you do it?
Here he is, sir, the incredible Seymour Krelbore. The owner of Fabulous Audrey 2, the most amazing and largest identified plant.
So this is Seymour Krelbore. We've been trying to reach you, baby. Have your phones been busy? Did you get our telegram?
I don't think so.
Well, it's a good thing I came down in person then. Pleased to meet you, kid. Skip Snip, William Morris Agency. Forget the cable we sent you. It's nice to meet me. The pleasure is yours. Now let my firm represent you. We want to book you on lecturing tours. College Campus Rotary Club. The kind of bookings my office can do. Show the plant, then talk, answer questions. It's educational, lucrative too.
My future's starting, I've got to let it. Stick with that plant and gee, my bank account will thrive. What am I saying? No way, forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep that plant alive. I take these offers, that means more killing. Who knew success would come with messy, nasty streams? I sign these contracts, that means I'm willing to keep on doing bloody, awful, evil things. No! No! There's only so far you can bend. No! No! This nightmare must come to an end. No! No! You've got no alternative, Seymour, old boy. Though it means you'll be broke again and unemployed. It's the only solution, it can't be avoided. The vegetable must be destroyed. But then there's Audrey, lovely Audrey. If life were tawdry and impoverished as before, she might not like me, she may not want me. Without my plan, she might not love me anymore.
They say the meek shall inherit.
Where do I sign?
No, the book doesn't lie.
Right on the line.
It's not a question of merit.
That'll define.
It's not the man that supplies.
Copies mine.
You'll make a fortune, we swear it.
Could it go wrong?
If on this
all about you, isn't it? Just give me some peace and quiet, or I'll tell him the truth.
Don't get cute with me. I made you, and I can break you.
Go ahead. Break me. You think it's easy living with the guilt?
Oh, cut the crap and bring on the meat.
If only you eat meat. If only you touch a mouse or flies, but no. You're so particular.
Come on, Quailborn, feed me. I ain't had since Bushnick, and that was a week ago.
Look, just hold out one more night. That's all I ask. Life magazine will be here in the morning to take our pictures.
And then you'll find me somebody.
And then you'll never be hungry again. I promise.
Chow time, Quailborn! Food! Food! Food!
Shut up! Shut up! Stop squalling! You're driving me crazy! Just shut up, will you? Shut up! Shut up!
Oh, Seymour, what's the matter?
It's the matter. Don't you think I know it needs food? Don't you think I know it'll die if I don't feed it, and soon? Don't you think I'm trying to think of a way? Something, someone?
Seymour, you're hysterical! What's the big deal about a little plant food? I think running this place all by yourself is too much for you. When did you say Mr. Mushnick would be back?
Huh?
You know that note you told me he left you. He was going out to see his sister in...
Czechoslovakia. Right. He could be gone a very long time, Audrey. Audrey, can I ask you something?
Anything.
Well, just suppose for a second that there'd never been an Audrey II. That I was just a nobody, nothing. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
What's settled? A gun?
And bullets. And rat poison. And a machete. Tomorrow morning, right after Life magazine takes our picture. You know who bites the dust.
Seymour!
That's right. We'll snap the photo. We'll be famous. I'll take that TV job. We'll live a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more night beatings. No more squalling for blood.
What feedings? What blood? Seymour, I don't understand. Knives, bullets, rat poison? You're scaring me.
There's nothing to be scared of. We'll go away from here. I'll take you to that little development you always dreamed about. And once we're there, we'll live happily ever after. I promise. Nice little house, nice little car, and no plants, no plants at all.
Seymour, you're talking so peculiar.
I'll explain everything in the morning. Just go home now, Audrey, please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything. Ouch!
Feed me.
Under no circumstances.
Feed me.
I will not, so stop asking.
Feed me!
Look, I can't take much more of this. I'll run down to the corner and get you a nice, rare roast beef. Maybe that'll hold you till Life magazine gets here.
No way.
Look, it's my last offer, yes or no.
It's better than nothing.
Done, fine, great. Don't think you're getting dessert.
I couldn't sleep, I took a Somanex, but voices in my head kept saying, go to Seymour, talk to Seymour. I drank some tea, but gee, the feeling wasn't gone. Seymour, sweetheart, tell me, darling, what's been going on?
That.
You're looking cute as can be.
Is someone in there?
You're looking mighty sweet.
Seymour! Seymour!
No, it ain't Seymour. It's me.
Oh my God!
Your friendly Audrey too. This plant is talking to you.
Don't believe it!
Believe it, baby. It talks.
Am I dreaming this?
No, and you ain't in Kansas neither.
Something's very wrong here.
Relax and go with it, doll. Do me a favor, will you, sweetheart?
A favor?
I need some water in the worst way. Look at my branch. I'm a goner, honey. Come on and give me a drink.
I don't know if I should.
Hey, little lady, be nice.
You just want water, right?
Sure do, I'll drink it straight.
All your branches are dry, poor thing.
Don't need no glass and no ice.
I'll get the can.
Don't need no twist of Summertime!
Audrey, are you okay?
Yes. Oh, no.
Oh, Audrey, please don't die. I need you. Please, please don't die.
No. The plant just said the strangest thing just then. It said that Orin and Mr. Mushnick were already inside.
Oh, it's true. I did it. I fed them to it.
And that's what made it so big and strong and... You're so famous?
I've done terrible things, Audrey, but not to you, never to you.
But I want you to, Seymour.
What?
When I die, which should be very shortly, feed me to the plant so that I can bring you all the wonderful things you deserve.
You don't know what you're saying. Oh,
but I do. It's the one gift I can give you. And if I... in the plant, that means I'm part of the plant. And in a way, we'll always be together. Oh. You wash my tender leaves. You smell my sweet perfume. You water me and care for me. You see me bud and bloom. I'm feeling strangely happy now, contented and serene. Oh, don't you see?
That's him, Miss Martin. He's right in there.
Thanks, sweetheart. Wait for me. Crowborn, Seymour Crowborn.
Leave me alone.
Pat Martin, Licensing and Marketing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. Have I got a gilt-edged proposition for you?
I'm not interested.
Let me explain in more detail. It's a very simple licensing deal. We take cuttings from the plant, develop little Audrey 2s, and sell them to florists across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America will have one. I have a truck waiting outside in some pots. If you don't mind, we'll start planting right now. Imagine, boy, Audrey 2s everywhere. Why, with right advertising, this thing could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops?
Much bigger!
Every household in America, thousands of you, eating! That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
You caught me, Sherlock. Ugh.
We're not talking about one hungry plant here. We're talking about world conquest!
And I want to thank you.
You're a monster, and so am I.
Feed me.
You ain't the only thing I ever loved.
Do me. Ugh.
Take that! And that, and that, and that, and that, and that!
Give up, Grandma.
Never! Here, rat poison. Eat it! Eat that, eat it, eat it, eat it!
Give up, small fry.
You may be tough on the outside, but from the inside, in that pod, I'll hack you to bits. Open up! Mm-mm. Open up! Mm-mm. Open up!
Mr. Crowborn? Mr. Crowborn? All right, ladies, now all you have to do is snip some of the smaller leaves and replant them in those pots. Truck's waiting outside. Open the van, boys! We're ready to start loading!
Across America, events which bore a striking resemblance to the ones you have just seen began occurring. Oh, yeah.
Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed. Unsuspecting jerks remain to California.
California.
Thank you.
your motor running. Head out on the highway, looking for adventure. And whatever comes our way, yeah, darling, go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. Fire all of the guns at once and explode into space. I like smoking lightning. Heavy metal thunder, racing with the wind.